Hello, audience. Thank you for joining us today. MIFFI has started screening its curated collection of Panorama films. And in this Panorama section of MIFFI 2021, we will be showcasing 11 films by 10 Indian filmmakers that focus on vanishing cultures. We have curated this section with an aim to share with our audience the importance of our broader mission and to illustrate the spirit of the festival. Starting today, the Panorama section will run up to the 22nd, and it will include daily online discussions with the makers of these films. And this will also provide a chance for the audience to interact and ask questions. So today we have with us an extra special guest, Meghnad of Akhra Ranchi, who directed the film Gaadi Lohar Daga Mel, along with filmmaker Biju Topo. Meghnad ji is a filmmaker and an activist working out of Jharkhand for the last 4 decades. He has been involved with the people's struggle against destructive development and considers filmmaking as an extension of his social and cultural work. He is the recipient of several national and international awards for his work in giving voice to those sections of people who remain unheard. A tremendous personality. In the short period of time that I've interacted with him, I have been tremendously influenced. Warm welcome, sir. Meghnad.
Thank you.
So I would like to begin this interaction by asking about the context of the film. How did you identify the Lohar Daga Mel as a subject for your film? Was this a project that you always had in mind? Was this planned beforehand? Or was it a spur of the moment exercise? Like when you heard that the train service was going to be discontinued, is that when you suddenly decided that a movie like this has to be made?
My friend, Dr. Ram Dayal Munda, unfortunately, he is no more there. He used to sit down with me and we used to discuss on what will be the future of cinema in Jharkhand, what type of thing is there. And those were the days in the 90s and 2000. Those were the days then where we were making a music album. And music album, in a way, we used to copy certain Bollywood, Hollywood thing and, you know, dance on the screen, which was to be in more or less, you know, it was like a vulgar copying of Bollywood, and that too in a vulgar way. So Ram Dayal ji used to ask me, can we not do something where we can sit and see our film in a family gathering? So that was in the back of my brain. How can we see our own film sitting with our family? And that was the time that, you know, I came to know that this train is going to end in next few days. So the idea came in my mind and I invited Dr. Ram Dayal Munda ji for my in Accra that let us plan something. I had a leg fracture, so I could not move. I was just in my thing. So Munda ji came and other two singers came. I just tell you, like, that this people you will see in the film, in today's date, in the last, we made this film in 2004 and 5, and in today's date, in the last 15, 16 years, all the three people are Padma Shri. Ram Dayal ji was the Padma Shri at first in 2010, and later on the other Mukund Nayak, and then Madhu Mansoori. Anyhow, so when I called them to my place, and we decided that we must do something in this train so that we can document the train which is going to stop after 100 years. The train ran from Ranchi to Lohar Daga for 100 years, and it is going to stop. So what do we do? So that is how we planned. And what we planned is very simple. We said nothing. People were always thinking that there will has to be a lot of acting, lot of this, lot of that. I said nothing. Let us do something. We will just go for a picnic and we will sing songs. Only one condition, let the original writer of the song sing the songs. So the who is the singer will who has written the song will sing. Second thing, let the song has something relation to the train and the life of the region. So this is the two thing that was in mind, and that is how we decided what to do in film. That is how we went to document that thing. I tell you one a little more on that. I had a friend just before that from Australia, and he had visited us. So he was telling the story how many of the indigenous people were angry on this Hollywood cinema and all that. And that is how they said that, you know, many of us wanted to make film and we went with our camera. So many people said, what are you going to do with your camera? So they were very angry people. They said, I don't know what I will do. Then why are you making film? I know what I must not do. So all those Hollywood films, what they are doing, we will not do.
Yeah.
So that type of thing was also in our head. We will not do all those dances and all those things. We will just have a picnic. And that is how the film has come out in front of you now.
Yes, that simplicity really comes through. It feels like I have spent a day with all of you there. That's really interesting. And it is tremendous to hear that all three singers have Padma Shri right now. That is a fantastic story by itself. But I would like to know a little bit more about the train itself. Could you tell me a little bit more about the Lohardaga train? Can you paint a picture? How big is it? How fast is it? Who gets into it? How do they behave? What's the atmosphere, general atmosphere like? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yes. This train, in today's day, we have a normal big train today. And this train today, from here to Lohardaga, and here is traveling is 70 kilometers by train length is 70 kilometers. And in today's day, there are 8 times the train goes from Lohardaga to Ranchi 8 times today.
Yeah.
But in those days, in the early days, when it was a small meter gauge train, narrow gauge train, that time the train is to start from here at in the morning 6 o'clock. By 12 o'clock, it is to reach Lohardaga. The 70 kilometer is to take 6 hours. Those days, and from there it will start at 12:30 or something, and reach here in the evening at 6:30, something. So only one day, one train is to go, and that was the train that local people is to come and go, and nothing, you know, bus and other things were also not that frequent, and train was cheaper, so people all there, and you will see in the film also. Lot of vegetable vendors, this and that, labor, worker, they used to travel and come back by that train. So that was the lifeline for that 100 years from here to Lohardaga. And from Lohardaga onward, again from bus journey, people will take from that. So this is the thing that was made in 1900 and it had started in 1902 and then it ended in 2004.
What is the train generally like? What are the kind of people who come into it? What are the activities that happen in the train?
That was the only, and it was so slow that if people wanted to, they can also ask the, when they are standing in the train, if people will show a hand, the train will stop. people who get up, they can. So it was just, and basically it was running with three bogies, bogies or four. Sometime it used to have two bogies of goods. Goods train. It was not every day, but maybe 2 or 3 days a week they used to have goods bogey. If you very minutely see our film, there will be in some time you will see also goods bogey added to
it. In the middle.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So that is how. And for me, you know, when you see the film, you will see like my like our old grandfather, when he's walking the stick, he will move like this, like this. This train also was like a grandfather, you know, when you will see you in the thing, like a moving like this a little bit with his rice beer or whatever, his little drunk, and he's moving like this, like this. Yeah. So the train, like Hrithik Ghatak's Ajantrik, the train also had its own life, the own bearing of things.
A very nice comparison of comparing it to a grandfather. It does feel like somebody has gone by. So has there any attempt been made to either resume that track or even somehow preserve it in some way? Is that something that is happening?
I tell you, the greatest tragedy of things. We, the people who can think that they have some dreams, are not the people who are in power. The people who are in power have their dreams, I don't know where. That is there. I and Ramdeal used to think, why don't they keep this one single line, leave it, and make another by the side of it, a modern line, and let this be like a heritage train. People may come just to travel on this. We were always talking on that. But that did not work out in the present generation. And the biggest joke of it, I will tell you, is that we had made this film illegally.
Oh.
Illegally. Because for that, in order to make that thing, we had to take permission. And that time the railway gave us 40 days to pay 4 lakh rupees to shoot in the tree. So we went just a picnic and we came back. When we made this film, Lalu Prasad Yadav was the railway minister at that time. So someone advised me that, Meghnad, it's so good, you know, you give it to Lalu Prasad, he will keep it in the railway museum. But some of the bureaucrats said that, he will keep it in the museum, but he can also arrest you and put it in the museum because this is an illegal thing. This is an illegal film.
Yes.
So what you see is an illegal film, and that because it is illegal, it cannot be kept in the museum.
So it was never sent to Lalu Prasad.
Pardon?
Did you send it to Lalu Prasad? No.
No, I had not tried. I don't know which minister or which fellow is will be good or which will be not good. For me, I don't know. So it is not that I have tried to search in Railway Museum what are the present things that is there in other old, and I only found out one the thing which was very mechanically made. This is a train which is going, this is like that. So it did not have the texture of literature, culture that we tried to put. So maybe someone else can give me some information. It's not. But if you try to see Bessel White's Nightmare that was there in that we hear when we learn filmmaking, Nightmare, that type of poetic thing is not there. I think that this was a poetic film, but if someone still wants, I am ready to give it. I don't want any money.
Yeah.
Make this illegal film legal and keep it.
So one of the highlights of the movie was the very, very powerful songs in it. They were both beautiful and emboldening. It gave me great courage listening to it. Even though I've never been to Jharkhand, I have fallen in love with Chando and Hira and Madhu, all these men and women that they sing about. Who are these folk singers and how have they stirred up such powerful emotions? And how did these songs come to be selected? What is the basis of the selection of songs? How was it arranged together? What was the idea behind all of it?
First of all the people who are there had a little bit of politics of Jharkhand. So they are part of the Jharkhand movement that was there for last three decades before the formation of Jharkhand also. Ramdeal ji himself was part of the ideologue of Jharkhand movement, although he was the vice chancellor, and Ramdeal ji is a linguist and he used to teach in America for 20 years, and then he, on the request of the people of Jharkhand, he had left the job in there and they had come. And Ramdeal ji is a cultural icon, and he's a singer, drummer, and as you see, he can play flute like that. Same is Mukund Nayak. Mukund Nayak also was in Jharkhand movement, and Madhu Mansuri was also in Jharkhand movement. So, and the song that Ramdeal, Mukund, and they were part of the Jharkhand movement and the cultural milieu of Jharkhand movement of those days. So, songs that was chosen. So, there you can see about five songs in the film. Altogether in the train, we had sang about seven or eight. But then, you know, so there was nothing before getting up in the train also, we had not said decided which song everyone will sing. Whatever was coming spontaneously was sung, and whatever that was the way I would like to make film. That's why that's everything went spontaneous. Whatever did not meet with things, I did take out. I tell you one more technical thing of the film. When we were making this film, there was no musician, no? There was no drum, there was nothing in the thing. It was just singing. No? So you will see all the songs without any musical accompaniment. No one is playing.
Yeah.
So we at point felt, you know, it will look boring. So we went to a studio and we tried to, again with music, try to lip the song. But when we saw that was not coming that well. So let's sacrifice the music.
Yes.
And so we sacrificed the music and we kept the thing because the natural thing is showing natural. And you know, sometimes that old train, the way it is going, it is looking like it is the percussions of the music. So that we said that is very good for us.
Yes.
That was what we were doing over there.
So, being an activist, I'm sure that there are layers to the film, and you also just said that this was also, the others were also part of the Jharkhand movement. So, apart from just documenting the last ride of the Lohar Daga Mail, when I think about it, at some point of time, the singer also mentions about being strangers in our own lands. So what are the other concepts the movie deals with when it comes to the question of identity and community of the Jharkhand?
I tell you. When we will analyze, because it's a local songs here, with a little bit of subtitle, you have understood. But there are many layers in the the song that Ramdeal ji is singing, he will not get a time like this ever. So, धरो धरो वीर धरो धनु तीर धरो निज माटि लगिया समय सन आवे न कतने लक्ष्य भेदिन लगिया धरो धरो वीर धरो धनु तीर सो दिस सॉन्ग इज टेलिंग माय बॉय दिस इज द बेस्ट टाइम दैट कम फॉर द मदरलैंड कम फॉर फाइट फॉर द थिंग. You know, this is like, you know, like pre-British people are singing for the Charan Kobi before the British, how they were singing for the nationalist song. So this was, Mundaji's song was very much like that. Same thing when it comes to Mukund Nayak. And you know, Banalin Pardesi Ni Jighare. So you are, you know, सुनरसिका बिना अखरा कर कोना नागपुरी भेली झारखंडी भेली तेरे बाहरी ऊपरे झारखंडे बनली परदेसी निज घरे इन इन आवर ओन लैंड वी आर बिकमिंग फॉरेनर्स दैट इज इट्स सो पॉलिटिकल यू सी दिस सॉन्ग इज सो पॉलिटिकल स्ट्रांग पॉलिटिकल सॉन्ग्स सो यू कैन से दैट दिस फिल्म इज अ वेरी पॉलिटिकल फिल्म इन दैट वे बट इट्स नॉट स्टैंडिंग ऑन द मार्चिंग सॉन्ग एंड ऑल दैट पॉलिटिकल द कल्चर ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स सेम थिंग व्हेन इट कम्स टू मधु मंसूरी ओहो बोथ दैट चांदो यू आर टेलिंग and the way we had edited, and I tell you, the editor is from your Kerala, Ajit. Ajit has edited
yes.
that film. We had ordinary people who were traveling. There was a beautiful small girl that is there. So we had taken a lot of shots of that. So that girl became Chandu of our thing.
Yeah. And
Ramdeal used to very much say, Meghnath, I have never seen such a beautiful heroine in any other but it was nothing planned, nothing.
Yes.
Because when we are traveling, Biju had taken a lot of shot of that girl. And there is a boy looking from outside from the window. Biju had taken a lot of shot of that boy. So it is like Chandu. So it has come out like that. And last song of Madhu Mansuri, that song is a very it is like a song that is describe the landscape of Jharkhand. Like when we see Rabindranath's song Janagana Mana, and you know, and he is describing the landscape of things. This Madhu Mansuri has the whole thing, the layer by layer, you know, he is talking about what type of food we eat. He talks about what are the festival we have. He's talking about chal re chal ghisri khel, gaadi ho lohar taka mel. Chal re chal ghisri khel, bina engine, bina tel, gaadi lohar taka mel. You know, in our childhood, when in the rock, we used to just slip, play the slip game, you know, where our pant is to get pant fat jata. That type of khisri khel in a rock. And this is the train, like, you know, and for that khisri khel, you don't have to buy ticket. There is no engine, there is no oil. And gari lohar taka mel is like that. So he's comparing our playing in the childhood with the train. Same way, he's comparing the woman with her khopa, उसमें जो cast full है, तो every paragraph and every layer is comparing the landscape and people and things of Jharkhand. Ramdeal ji used to tell that this one single song was enough to get a PhD. It's in so many layers. So we are very fortunate that song was sung in the train and we could put it in the film.
You have been making films for almost 4-5 decades now, okay, and mostly independent documentary films, politically charged films. And there are other filmmakers also like Shashi, Charat Chandran, Patwardhan, all of them used to make films like that. And technology has changed, equipment has changed, perhaps ways of life has also changed. How do you see the growth or direction of this current era? How do you understand the changes?
As I said that, you know, filmmaking was the extension of my social commitment. So we were social worker and whoever, even Anand Patwardhan's recent book that has again come out from Kerala, James has written. And when I was reading, Anand is telling that it's by accident that I have become a filmmaker. I didn't want to be a filmmaker. So Anand and also Shashi and Sarat are very good friend of mine. There is a photograph of I, Shashi and Sarat like three monkeys of Gandhi. So we were friends, and all of us, when we were making film, our first commitment from Anand to us is the people. And I learned the film in celluloid first with Tapan Bose and Suhasini. But I knew that we will not collect that much of money to make a celluloid film. It was so costly. Anand Patwardhan, in the beginning, first two or three films he made in celluloid, four films. But later on, he also left celluloid and he came up with the technology. You see, what you and I have to understand, and all my younger generation must understand, that the invention of all this technology, from the very beginning of still camera to those celluloid camera, they were all done to make it pro people things, you know. And I can go on length, I'm not going into that. And so also in the last three decades, all this technology is coming down pro people. My teacher used to tell that in the celluloid days, that one day you have to understand that one day our camera will not be that heavy. Our camera will be like a pen.
Yeah.
That will work. And today, see, all our mobiles are just like a pen. Na? We are documenting things in this mobile. And so I want to tell to my friends that technology is coming to your hand. Not only making technology, also screening technology. At one point of time when we used to, and also in your place, John Abraham and others, they used to carry 16 millimeter projector from all over Kerala, from this part, that point, and show film. Today it's so easy, you know, you take a projector and a sound box, and with your laptop, you screen wherever you want to. So making the film is becoming easier, screening the film is becoming easier. Sir, who is stopping you now? Let's do whatever we want. That is what is the thing, and that is how we are working with our group. One of the reasons that we made this Akhada about 25 years back is that our voices, the Adivasi voices for our case here, maybe the Dalit voices in other places, those voices were not coming up in an eye level. They were coming from top angle type of daya maya, are ye bichare log kitne mar rahe hain. They are poor, poor are dying. No. We want to tell our voice, our thing, our culture, our folklore. That was not coming through. And that is what most of these years we have. If you try to see a film that we made, Kora Raji, it was a film on our people who are in tea gardens for last 200 years. The songs that was there in the film were all the tea garden laborers used to sing in there. So the song becomes the spine of the film of narration. And then we put things, how they went 200 years ago and how, what is the condition now. So that is how we are trying to document history. That is how we are trying to document in this film that you have seen in document. In progressive songs. In the coming days, you will show how we have documented folklores. And you will see that. And I personally feel that animation is a very good medium of talking on folklores. And that is how you have seen the film that we have said, Mundari Sishti Katha. But animation is a costly medium. I mean, animation is costly medium. Everyone cannot. In today's date also, if you don't have your own animator, it is very, very costly medium to make up real quality work. So we have to find out some other processes of talking any our folklores and documenting it. And folklore, another thing, because this is a folk music festival, I am trying to tell you, folklore is very, very, very essential for the oppressed section of the society, whether Dalit, Adivasi, to get back their dignity, because the mainstream culture is trying to play on your dignity. mainstream culture, they always talk about their folklore. Ramayana and Mahabharata is going on. But you know, when Ramdayalji was there, Ramdayalji knew very much. He was a teacher of Sanskrit. Adivasi person, he used to teach Sanskrit in Chicago. So he knew those stories, and he was trying to also twist the Ramayana to the Dalit causes. I give you an example, like Ekalavya. Dronacharya asked for the term of Ekalavya. And Ramdayalji, he makes a chow dance on that if today Ekalavya asks for term, Ekalavya will not cut but run after them, Dronacharya. And to tell you, it's a laughing thing, wherever this Dharma was going, chow dance was going, the mask of Dronacharya was not brought. And I had beard like this. So Ramdayalji said, you act as Dronacharya. So what I'm trying to tell you is that the present system, the people who are in power, the mainstream, they will talk about their folklore always, Ramayana and Mahabharata. Where are you and I? Where are the Dalit and the subalterns? The Dalit and the subalterns will also have to come with their story and interpret it in today's context and try to take energy out of it. That is what this folklore festival, whatever you are trying to do, that must be the real aim of thing. What we want to achieve from this. Achieve is that the subaltern people get energy out of the goodness of it.
That is very much our hope and direction and aim. We hope to achieve all of that. Thank you, Meghnaji, for coming, spending so much time with us and inspiring us with your words. It has been a real pleasure having you. Please, continue.
Before ending, I just want to tell all, my teacher is to tell that Meghnaji, you have to understand that we are moving against the wave. We are moving against the wave and we are minority. But we have to prove our existence positively. Although we are minority, we have to prove our existence positively. So in the whole cycle of cinema and all these things, where are we in front of Amitabh Bachchan? Nothing. So we are minority. But we have to prove our existence positively so that tomorrow, all this alternative against the wave things also become mainstream. If some of our all progressive friends try to take up all thing to screen things for children, I tell you, in the last, you know what is going on in the country and the hate that is going on in the country and how the children's brain is full with hate. So we have to work on something. And I made a whole package of cinema for peace, for children and others. So what I'm trying to tell you that tomorrow we have to be the alternative against the way people. We are thankful to people like you who are trying to make this alternative against the way things to be shown to the people. So I want to thank you all for organizing this type of a festival of this against the wave things. Thank you.
Thank you, Meghnaji. All we need is your blessings. We will achieve our goals.
I'm happy that I am in the beginning of the festival. Only you have given me the honor to be part of it. Thank you for that.
Yes. Thank you once again. Thank you to all the audience who joined us. We will continue the series. Enjoy. Cheers.